What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to be going over how to set admins on a vRising server. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Hosting your own vRising server can be a lot of fun, but with that weight on your shoulders, it might be easier for you if you had some commands to help you out. For example, things like teleporting players or giving them items. But to do those things, you're going to have control as an admin. Other than maybe helping players out, it's also important to make sure you have the commands that you need to monitor your players for smoother gameplay. All of these functions are easily done by giving yourself admin privileges, which may seem a bit confusing, but it's actually pretty quick and easy to do. Let's go over how to set admins in vRising. Head towards the steamid.io page and type in your Steam username in the lookup field. This will give you some basic information, but you're going to want to focus on the Steam ID 64 value. Copy this number, and then head into your Apex panel and stop your server. Click Customizations in the top left, and then find the Admin List option under Server Settings, and then paste your Steam ID 64 number in here. If you're adminning more than just yourself, you can separate these numbers with commas and then one space afterwards. After this, your changes are going to save automatically, so click on your username at the top of the page to return to the main panel, and then click Restart so that it applies the changes. Once you've done that, you can join the server and then open Options and head towards General in the menu. Make sure that the console enabled is activated, and then leave the menu and press tilde on your keyboard to open the console. Enter Admin Auth in the text box, and then you should get a chat confirmation message, which is going to mean that it worked. Now that you're an admin on the server, you can use commands. There are a lot to choose from, but here is a list of the most important ones to get you started. If you're curious about all of the other commands that you're able to use, then make sure to check out the vRising console wiki page that will be linked down below. If you are unable to become an admin, first double-check your Steam ID 64 number to make sure there are no mistakes. After that, make sure you enable the console in your game and type in admin auth, or the process will not work completely. If you got the admin confirmation message but you're not able to use certain commands, make sure that the commands are being typed correctly. Each command is written a certain way with certain parameters. If you have any questions about how to write out a specific command, I recommend going to the vRising console wiki page to learn the uses for every one. Giving yourself or others you trust the power of being an admin can make hosting your vRising server so much easier. With these new powers, you can choose to help your players, or you can just choose to keep an eye on them in case something goes wrong, giving you no option but to ban or kick a player. Whatever you decide to do with these commands, it will completely change the way you're able to run your game. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.